President Obama recently urged Congress again to make immigration reform a priority.
If we're serious about economic growth, it is time to heed the call of business leaders, labor leaders, faith leaders, law enforcement, and fix our broken immigration system.
Conservatives in the House, though, are suspicious of amnesty for illegal immigrants. They say this is not the year for action.
If we have an administration that is making it harder for people to use the legal system, and then they're advocating for amnesty for 11 million people, what you will see is that you're going to have more illegals and less people coming here legally. And that's what this administration seems to want at this point.
But if we can secure the border, why not address those who live and work here illegally? We've got some tough questions for Derek Morgan, who is in charge of domestic and economic policy at the Heritage Foundation.
Derek, what does the Heritage Foundation think Congress should actually do on immigration reform this year?
Well, I think that unfortunately and regrettably, the president hasn't shown that he's a true partner in this process, that he could be trusted to enforce any new immigration laws, since he's not really enforcing the laws that are on the books already. And he's already circumvented immigration law with respect to large numbers of unlawful immigrants already in the country, where he said he's no longer going to target them for enforcement. So for a lot of reasons, Republicans don't have a lot of reason to do anything on immigration reform this year.
Would you agree that the immigration reform, as the president himself has said, it's a broken system?
Absolutely. In fact, we've called for a number of years that a step-by-step approach for immigration reform would really be looking at fixing the border, making sure that we have workplace enforcement, and then also looking at reforming the legal immigration system, so those who do want to come to the United States legally can do so.
But you're telling the American people that we've got a broken system, you admit that, but you don't want to do anything about it right now.
Well, it's not really a matter of what Congress can do about it. It's really up to the president. The Constitution vests him with the authority to enforce the laws, and that is really where the immigration problem is breaking down right now, is we need to see that the president is serious about enforcing the law before that we can take any of these other measures.
As you well know, there are at least 11 million folks here who've come different ways and through different avenues, but are here illegally. Many of them, however, they're contributing to society. Many of them have jobs. They are contributing to the economy. Why is there no reason from the Heritage Foundation side to say, look, we got to find a way to make these people part of the larger economy legally, to get them out of the shadows, to give them some dignity?
I certainly understand that argument. I think I would come at it from this approach. You look at amnesty as a policy. It's not a new policy. We tried it in 1986. In that instance, Congress, about 3 million unlawful immigrants in the country, Congress said we'll have border security and we'll have workplace enforcement, but we'll also do a one-time only amnesty for the 3 million who are here now. Unfortunately, if you fast forward to today, in just a generation, we're looking at now 11 million people in the country unlawfully. So we found there that it won't work.
But just because it didn't work under President Reagan in that particular avenue, isn't there a way to go about making these folks legal even without giving them full citizenship? I mean, you call it amnesty. A lot of other folks say, no, it's just about giving them the opportunity to come forward, get themselves legal, and become real contributors to society. Why are you opposed to that?
Well, I think under any reasonable definition, that would be amnesty, granting the legal status. If you went above and beyond that and granted citizenship, that would be amnesty plus a citizenship. So if you look at how that term's been used in the past, for example, President Ford decided that he was going to grant clemency or amnesty to those who evaded the Vietnam draft. In that clemency order, he decided that people would have to do public service, but it was widely reported, and correctly so, as an amnesty. And that's really what this policy is, too. It's folks who have broken the law, but now are being told that they're not going to have to face the punishment for that.
Join us next time for more tough questions on immigration reform. For Derek Morgan of the Heritage Foundation.